The next person is Ben Lowrey. And I remember Ben because I have been doing this club for 11 years now. And Ben was one of the original members who came. And I always liked him. I always thought he's a sparky chap. And I could always see he was always so hungry for information and knowledge, always doing new things. And I've sort of seen him progress during the years. We've sort of reconnected quite a bit the last year or so, because I've been, you know, astounded and also inspired by a lot of his ideas and thinking. He runs a company called Circaplex, and he does tours of the UK teaching people to do handstands, among other things. It's really cool that he invited me to one of his events, and it was amazing. He transformed his village hall into this pulsing beam of like gongs and light and handstands. And I did my first ever handstand, so I was like, I thought at 54 that wasn't bad. So a big round of applause for Ben Lowrey, entrepreneur par excellence.
Thanks, Simon. Thank you, everybody. Nice to be here. I was just feeling a real reminiscence, actually. I don't come to London very often. I'm from Bristol. And it reminded me, around about 2005, whatever that is, over 10 years ago, I started coming to London, attending seminars and networking meetings, and, you know, and I was just loved the energy of that. And I attended Simon's event, that's where I first met him. And I'd go to Tony Robbins and go to Yes Group and anything I could find, there was a seminar, I'd show up, you know. I was just hungry for it. And I was a guitarist. I used to play guitar. I've never had a job. I think that's why Simon asked me to come along. I've always managed to do things I enjoy, things I'm passionate about, and you know. So yeah, thank you. Yeah, and I know. Oh, thank you. So, it reminds me of that, and I go to these seminars, and just being around all this energy of it inspired me. I created an online guitar lesson website. I turned my guitar lessons into an online business, and as a result of being in these kind of environments, so it kind of worked, you know, and I was doing really well. It was great, you know. I thought I'm going to be a billionaire in no time, you know. I got this down. This is easy, you know. Sales only go up, right? Anyway, eventually, I messed it all up. I won't bore you with the story, but I ended up getting in a mess. I ended up going bankrupt. So I kind of, you know, I did well for a bit and then lost it all. But it's weird. You really learn about yourself when you. When you fail, don't you? You know, you can kind of be. Sometimes you're plain sailing, and you kind of have a false sense of yourself from that. So I think you really learn about yourself more when things go wrong, in a way. So that's interesting, that. Something strange happened one year. My hair fell out. It all fell out. 2012. In a space of about a month, I met my mum one day for a coffee, and she said, "Your eyelashes are falling out." I said, "They are." And it was quite worrying at first. You know, I don't know what's going on. I don't know if I'm dying or something. I got no idea. And there was patches falling out. And in the space of about a month, it went. Wow. It just all gone, yeah. I dealt with it quite well. I somehow used it as a positive. I started exercising. I started going to the gym because I thought, I can't control this. There's nothing I can do about it. At first, I was quite arrogant. I thought, I got this. I'll do the Tony Robbins stuff. I'll drink wheatgrass. It'll grow back. It's, you know, easy. I'll do some cleansing, colonic. It's fine. It'll grow back. I gave up on that. That didn't work. Where was I? It got me into exercising. The only thing I could control, I couldn't control my hair, but I could change the way I looked in terms of, you know, it's like weightlifting and stuff. And so it was just like a natural thing. I just started doing that. It was like I was just drawn to that. And so it ended up as a real positive. You know, I felt better about myself. You know, I started to quite enjoy this new look. I got my ears pierced, and, you know, I started going to yoga. I started learning handstands. In Bristol, there's a lot of circus acrobatics. There's a circus school. So I started going to dance classes. I go to ballet and contemporary and gymnastics and yoga and boxing and everything. And now I teach handstands. So I go around the country doing that. I teach handstands around the country. I put on full day events. That's the one Simon came to.
They're brilliant.
Thank you, Simon.
Brilliant.
Thank you. What I'm trying to do is combine, kind of have a little bit of a feel of a yoga retreat and a festival and like a fitness boot camp and somehow make a mixture of all those things. And so I bring in dance teachers, I bring in yoga teachers, I had a gong bath and food and had a fire pit outside. So I'm trying to bring all these elements together. It's a lot of fun. So yeah, thank you. So so if anybody wants to come to a handstand class sometime, yeah, you're welcome to look me up. Oh, I'm in Guildford soon in December, I think. That's probably the closest one to here. But it's so nice to be in this environment again, actually, in this kind of energy, because I really disconnected after I went bankrupt and I kind of retreated, and being here with you all, it kind of makes me realize that it'd be nice to actually have more of this. I'd like to reconnect with these kind of environments again. So I appreciate you being here, having me. Thank you. Thanks, Simon.
There you go. Some people would have taken it as a negative. And Ben, I have to say something. You look so much more handsome now than you did 10 years. You look fantastic. You really do. And it's amazing. You can take what might be perceived as a challenge or a negative and you can transmute it into a positive. And that's what alchemy is. Alchemy is taking something that's sick or diseased or difficult and transmuting it, transforming it into something better, something that's healthy, living, vibrant.